Wednesday morning, March 30th, 2016. You continue on with your life and career. Or accept the offer of a campaign back into politics.
Thank you.
Rather out of the blue. Saturday night, 10 o'clock call. Hi, I'm so those side bugs who Atlanta Easter Sunday. Having non-stop meetings. Even met with the Secret Service and White House staff yesterday when Obama was in town. Thank you for doing that. And President Obama, we still need to have our talk. So, thank you for our staff's time and generosity yesterday, and glad we communicated. Still want my YouTube channels back up, regardless. And good to know we're in good standings. Thank you, Secret Service, for validation and verification with the potential candidate. Or maybe I'll surprise everybody. Decisions. Hi, how are you? Do you need a hand with the door? You got it? Okay. Things make you go. But, Ted Turner, your staff was amazing yesterday at the restaurant, and they put me in their booth. Rockstar.
Yeah, they give me a number one.
Sorry, missed you this trip, but truly A plus, and cool sitting in your private booth, and really appreciate it. And I did. They gave me the number. I'll get in touch with you. So when we both get time, but certainly some things I would like to discuss with you and get your wisdom and input on. It's been time since we've last talked, and it's overdue. I'm sure there's a lot of other things. Billy Jean, thanks for your coming down. Regardless, what's the wisdom? When we're both feeling at a different altitude. Oh, this trip's nonstop. So, what would you do if you were me? I'll be curious. Feel free to post your comments with the video. Would you continue going on and doing what you've been doing? Or would you get back into centuries of parody geopolitics and world leaders? And all the fun stuff you know is completely dysfunctional. You think entertainment, rock and roll, and stuff like that's dysfunctional? No, politics kicks its ass. The highest levels, it's so dirty and corrupt sometimes, I feel like I gotta take a shower when I shake hands with people. That's a joke. So I made a conscious decision as a child to change my name. So as not to be associated with the Klan. Political figures that I herald from. But on this trip I heard confirmation on several disturbing facts that I'm still deciphering how to deal with some of my relatives who are well-known political figures. Tragically, that truly happened to three of them and to Martin Luther King. To have the confirmation of what I already knew revalidated in my face again. Some of these things that I've done for years is a real wrestle. At what point was national security outright doing the right thing? Unfortunately, if you ask people in government, it always be national security, no matter how corrupt it is the priority. And then you ask yourself consciously and morally, do people deserve to know? And what are the risks for exposing those truths? And sadly, many people have lost their lives doing the right thing. Now the question becomes, is it time to declassify everything? Personally, exceedingly upset about texts and emails not being customized to your liking, just do me a favor. Let me know if you want text, email, or none. And we'll be happy to accommodate with any of the three, but we will not send custom emails when there's press releases and blast on stuff. So if you honestly expect when we're sending out tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of these things, I'm going to sit here and custom write one because you like it this long and this text and that size. Seriously, you self-indulgent people. get a clue. Go edit it or delete it, but stop calling me up in the middle of the night and complaining that things aren't perfect the way you want them in your life. Because frankly, I don't need that nonsense or bullshit. So if you're offended by the terminology, grow up and get over it. But stop being leeches and barnacles. I mean, people I hardly even know texting and calling me in the middle of the night asking me to get them into VIP parties and then upset when I send them a text about something else at the wrong date or time that might offend them. Listen, you're not paying me for this free information or these really cool events. So do me a favor. If you don't like the way you get things from me, just delete me from your contact database. Please don't ever call me again. Because frankly, we're not married, we're not engaged, and I don't need your drama, queens. Male and female, stop being absolute self-indulgent parasites. And by the way, none of you ever really say thank you. So if I just cut everybody off from the list and go by myself with some cool people who actually care and have manners and know how to say thank you and please, don't take it personal, because I just don't like being around parasites, barnacles, leeches, and bloodsuckers. You know, go swim in your own pool. I'm not your ship.